Hey guys, I'm TheYoloGeek. There are a lot of reviews regarding how insane the M1 Max chip is, but there are a lot of people wondering, is M1 Max an overkill? Is M1 Pro just sufficient for the real life? I have the same question. So today, I did a stress test in real life. Here are my situations. I always have tons of browser tabs open, and I do video editing quite a lot. They are in 4K, H.265, ProRes HDR videos, which are quite demanding. And meanwhile, I have all kinds of applications open in the background. Like right now, I'm presenting in the Keynote. But meanwhile, I have the numbers or the Excel. I have the pages or the words, and I also have my music turned down. You can tell it's playing. I also have my podcast, which is playing. I have my map open. I have the notes open. All right, so let's take into the intense video editing test first. So right now, here are all the video clips. The first kind is iPhone 13 Pro, the 4K 60 HDR video. The second type is the latest from the iOS 15.1, which is a ProRes 4K 30 HDR. The third kind is from my DJI Air 2S. It's in HLG HDR as well. The fourth kind is from my A7S III, which is encoded in the H.265, which is in high compression, and it's in HLG HDR video. All right, so I have already created the video project in the Final Cut Pro. So right now you can tell we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 tracks over here. And you can tell right now I just can browse it very easily and smoothly. Let's try to play back. All right, so right now all the different types of the video clips are running butter smooth. This is ProRes, this is DJI HLG, and this is A7S III high compression H.265 in HLG HDR as well. All right, so right now it seems like the M1 Pro can handle all these things very, very easily. Let's add some difficulty to the clips as in real life. Let's add some stabilization, and also let's add on some noise reduction. And let's play back instantly. So right now you can tell this clip is butter smooth without any of the buffering. So it's stabilized and also the noise has been deducted. So this is a very brief testing regarding the video editing, regarding a lot of the different types of video in 4K, in HDR, in ProRes. Let's test about the browser tabs we talked about earlier. In fact, I have the Safari open. So right now I'm on the Reddit, which is open. And if we go to the tabs here, I actually have opened 50 tabs already in the background. Meanwhile, we were doing the video editing. So let's open another, for example, like this Amazon thing. So you can tell everything is open already. So you can tell for the 50 tabs, it's everything is in real life. There are Reddit, Twitter, there are ESPN, there are New York Times, there are Amazon, eBay for shopping, there are Market Watch for stocks, and also some Wikipedias. What you are not aware of is that beyond these 50 tabs, there are actually one live game streaming on the ESPN. You can tell the quality is pretty good and it plays smoothly. Beyond that, I actually opened another HDR 4K video in the background on YouTube. Let's go to the full screen to take a look. It plays very smoothly and also it's in 4K HDR. So if you think M1 Pro is not strong enough, let's take everything into consideration. Right now, we have already edited so many 4K HDR ProRes tracks all at once, very smoothly. And meanwhile, on the background, there are 50 tabs. In addition, there are two video tabs in 4K HDR and ESPN streaming. So everything, including the Spotify podcast, the page, the number, the keynote, everything is running. Not to say right now I'm recording the screen. You can tell the resolution is wonderful as well. It takes much resources as well. So you can tell how impressive the M1 Pro is. And if you don't believe me, let's take a look about the specification. So this is 16-inch 2021 M1 Pro chip, and it only has 16 gigabytes, the base memory. It can handle all that. And for another thing, if you notice a battery here, right now we are actually on pure battery. There is no power adapter connected at all. So everything we just performed and tested are in the battery testing. One question I got for you guys is that, do you find my voice recording quality good? Because I didn't use any of the external microphones. I just use the built-in microphones from this MacBook Pro. So after this very brief but very intense real life stress testing, do you think you still need M1 Max, or do you think M1 Pro can handle all your needs? Please share your thoughts and your choice in the comments. Thank you. Hey guys, I'm TheYoloGeek. This is my very first video. If you like it, please like my video and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to follow me and let me know if you have any questions on Instagram and Twitter at TheYoloGeek. Thank you guys.